Today we are celebrating the birth anniversary of Rajarsi Janakananda. This gentleman with the beautiful face, you can just see he has awesome meditations. He was Yogananda's most advanced disciple. His birth name was James Lynn, and he was a multi-millionaire in America, an oil and insurance tycoon. So it certainly helps us understand that money and worldly success is not diametrically opposite to spiritual success. In fact, a lot of the principles that are needed for worldly success are the same ones: concentration, willpower, focus, energy. You know, that's all going to participate both in our search for God and in our search for outward fulfillment. So the only important thing here is not being attached and then using everything that we receive in offering to the Guru. And that's what Rajarshi did. And that is why so quickly he developed and progressed on the spiritual path. And so today, let's tune into what he must have felt as he offered everything that he did to the Guru. Let's try our best as well to offer everything that we do to our Guru, whoever your Guru is, and more importantly, the principle of the Guru, which is this absolute highest consciousness within us, that maybe we give it a form that will help our devotion and our love be focused more easily on something personal rather than something too impersonal. So hold your own Guru in your heart. We, of course, hold our Guru. And we hold Rajarshi especially today so that we can attune to his particular way of how he felt and received the Guru so quickly, so easily, so profoundly that we may learn from him as well. The first chant is the simplest of all, the most powerful of all, Jai Guru. Let's close our eyes for a moment. And let us each bring to mind, visualizing the image, the vibration, the form of our Guru. Gaze into his eyes. Feel his living presence at the point between the eyebrows. And having churned the ether, chanting Jai Guru, Jai Guru, Jai Guru, know that his consciousness is as close to you now as ever. This next chant is called, I am the bubble, make me the sea. And the words are, so do thou, my Lord, thou and I never apart. Wave of the sea, dissolve in the sea. I am the bubble, make me the sea. And this is the disciple's sincere call. My little ego, the little bubble, the wave of individuality. May I merge back into the sea of your infinite consciousness. I am the bubble, make me the sea. Thank you. I want us to visualize ourselves as waves on the ocean of our Guru's infinite consciousness, rising, trying to assert our individual reality away from Him, somehow thinking the higher we go, the more we will find that success we're looking for. The farther away we reach from Him, the more we will be unique and individual and special. But the life of Rajarsi especially shows us that it is closest to the ocean that you can achieve both an expanded consciousness but also an expanded, successful, fulfilled life in every way possible. So visualize your own wave now, joyfully, willingly wanting to return back into the sea, having spent eons, lifetimes, asserting that individual, only reality, separate. Now let us merge back into the ocean of bliss. With your heart open now, let us go into this next chant, talking about wanting to return back again through the simple words of Shri Guru Deva Om, the only reality that means anything to us right now is the power we receive from the Guru, Shri Guru Deva Om.
Thank you.
Let's close our eyes and uplift our gaze, straighten our spines. Let your shoulders relax. Let the Anahat Chakra open. Let the blessings of the Guru and his foremost disciple, perfect in every way, a perfect reflection of the Guru's consciousness, let both those energies enter into us. The grace of the Guru and the strength of the disciple, together combined. Feel them mixing in your heart, grace descending from the point between the eyebrows, and our strength as a disciple rising up from the base, both of them uniting and forming a deep bond of love, an eternal love that no one else can share with us. Meditate on that love, on that bond, on that promise. Rajarsi Janakananda's life is the fulfillment of that promise, and each of our lives that potential exists right now. But we must mold ourselves ever more perfectly in the image of the disciple. So take another minute, just allowing that to settle in, to reveal itself. Our final chant for this evening is one that was dedicated by Yogananda to Rajarsi. And this chant is called, I am the sky. The words are, I am the sky, Mother, I am the sky. I am the vast blue ocean of sky. I am the little drop of the sky. Frozen sky, frozen sky. It's talking about the infinite consciousness represented by the sky, that we are both the vast ocean of sky, yet we have frozen that consciousness into this body, into this experience of self. And that is the disciple and the guru's relationship as well, both the frozen individual reality, yet at the same time the vast infinite sky of omnipresence.
I am the sky. If you ever read the life of Rajarshi Janakananda or any letter that Yogananda sent him, wrote him, you can so clearly perceive the love that Yogananda had for this great disciple. Yogananda was so pleased with Rajarshi's exemplary life of being a businessman, fulfilling all his duties, responsibilities, having a wife, a daughter, and yet having a very deeply rooted spiritual life through his long hours of sadhana. He was in perfect attunement with his guru. And he was a perfect disciple in following his guru's guidance without questioning even for a moment. Once Yogananda jokingly told Rajarshi, "Never forget where your power comes from." And Rajarshi, as a little child, knowing what his guru meant, he replied, "No, Master, I will never forget the power that I have that flows through me is yours. It will be ever yours." And this is how we want to end this evening, by allowing the power of our guru to flow through us while we send the healing light, the joy and love that we have felt in our hearts throughout this kirtan. So let's very consciously to invite the presence of our guru or the divine and sending that power, that healing light into this world, visualizing the world in perfect harmony and balance with the cosmic laws. And with the power of Om, the vibration of Om. And we as perfect, transparent, pure channels of the divine, of our guru, let's wrap our hands together and while sending these waves of healing and harmony through the sound of Om, allowing the divine to transform, to uplift this world. Om. Shanti, shanti. Amen. Jai Guru.